Okay, you know, guys, yeah, I'm not gonna, you know, respond, but I said the first incident, I'm gonna say 100 times, it was not caused by them, it was caused by him. Okay, like I said, that is not the, it's each, this is the thing, when you were trying to find out information, especially like this, each thing has to be treated very separately, and then you put the pieces together when you explain the details. But you cannot assume, you know, this is the, you know, this is either in, if you find somebody who does readings or whatever, and if you, if you look at any sort of investigation, you can never make assumptions, because that is when you miss the points, the truth or the details. You cannot do that. Okay. So this is why I don't want to, like, oh, you know, you can never make the assumption that the outcome is the, you know, it's like something, just because this happened, it doesn't mean that that's how, you know, it's just the outcome of something. But you cannot make the assumption that because this happened, that is going to happen too. That is not how, you know, how you come make sense of bigger things. Okay, so this is it. Now, wow, guys, I'm like, whoa. So guys, now I'm going to ask, okay, since you mentioned Jared, let me just ask, okay, about Trump, and then ask about Barr. Is Trump somehow involved in his death? In other words, not, guys, as you know, from what I've seen of Trump, he's not the mastermind of anything. He's just an employee of the mob thing. I don't believe he is the biggest person. I don't. But let's find out, since he mentioned. Okay, so did Trump know this could happen, that this was going to happen? Did he okay it? Did he say, did you give him permission? Did he make it? You know, we don't know. Just as it happened with the guy Acosta, right? How he let him off the hook. It was a series of people who you know, there's a whole chain of command of things. But what is the involvement of Trump, if any? Okay, so I don't know. Let me just, I'm almost like, okay, is Trump, let me just do visions quickly, and then is Trump somehow involved in this? Why is it saying, it's saying this, but it's saying, it's kind of interesting here. It's telling me that not for the reasons we think. In other words, what I feel like, that Trump was not the person who ordered this, but they want to protect Trump. Why? Because the Trump lets the system go. In other words, guys, and I'm telling you, you know, this is reality. This is not conspiracy theory. The mob, I do believe simply connected to the Russian mob or mobs. Okay, I don't know. That it says that Trump's election was orchestrated by them at large with other players, but it, you know, they made it happen in many ways, or there's a lot of people involved. So if the truth about Trump comes out to this extent, or through him, or, you know, it's not just, it's like, is that Trump in a way protects the human, we know that, right? Factually, he protects human traffickers, but also that it would expose, this is the thing, the financial structure of all of this and how it works, it would expose the whole scheme, all of the people behind the scenes. So they didn't want it. So in other words, I feel like Trump didn't directly participate, but he knew it could happen. Okay, so let me just see. Did Trump have to okay this, or did he know? But guys, you know, it's showing that Trump is not in command. He's not in charge. He's a soldier in a lot of ways. Okay, he does what he's told. And at this level, he does not have the power to, how do I say this, guys? You know, he doesn't have the power to order something. It's like he's a much lower level than we think. That's what he's saying. Because they put all, guys, they're saying this mob people, that's what I'm saying. They put all the money in for his election. They pay him. He's an employee of theirs. So it's not as if he can be like, oh, I'm going to kill that. He could tell that to his whatever base. But he can't tell these guys what to do. That's not how it works. Because they paid him his whole life. They paid for his buildings. They paid for this and that. And he knows it. He knows about this quid pro quo, literally. Okay. So, oh my God, guys, it's kind of crazy. So this is it. Okay. So what about Barr? Did he know something? Did they know? How did they get to, let's say, the Department of Corrections? How did it happen? They're saying, oh, it's like, guys, it's the mob thing. It's a mob thing. Okay. They're saying it's like very high level. They have a lot of money. They have a lot of, you know, empowered of intimidation. They have, like, it's almost like, guys, you know, it's dangerous. I don't know. It is, I know, it reminds me of, like, you know, Al Capone, you know, when he was powerful in Chicago back in the 20s or whenever it was. It was like he controlled every, you know, something like that, very powerful. So these things can happen, okay? I used to be like, oh, fear mongering, I don't believe this stuff, but that's what it looks like. He's such a high level person that they kind of had to make it happen. It was risky. It was risky, but, you know, for some reason, that's what I think. That's my sense. Okay. Wow. Oh my God. Wow. Can you believe it? Yeah. So in other words, at first, guys, I did think it was some sort of guard person who could have been, but I don't think the way that they did it, it was so professional. Okay. It was not a person who was like, who could do it on the side or like, you know, this is not just the kind of thing that a person who is not a professional can do. It's very, you know, the person has to have their blood, you know, has to be like cool. You know, you cannot be a person who does it. Oh, maybe I need this for money. No, it has to be like a, you know, pro, like real pro type person. Okay. Wow. Guys, can you believe it? Oh my God, it's crazy. Oh my God. So, Barr. Does Barr know? What does Barr think? Does Barr know? What does Barr know? Is Barr involved? How is it feeling? How is Trump feeling? Is Trump involved? How is it feeling? Is Barr involved? How is it feeling? Barr's not, he woke up. Oh, guys, you know, he was told. I feel like he was, because he was in bed. He was woke. Somebody called his house. He was sleeping and the phone rang and they told him this had happened. So brace yourself. Okay, they were saying. So they called right away. It was like, went to the Department of Justice. Like when he went to the hospital, like right as you were taken to the ambulance, they called like the highest levels of the government to say, okay, call Christopher Wray, call him, like all these people. Okay. So he's like, they're on. You know, he's afraid, actually. Barr is afraid for his life, honestly. I feel like, because he knows these people. He knows it. I feel like he's down with them in some way, okay? I'm sorry. How could he not be? Let's go, right? That's my sense, okay? That's my sense, and that's why he does as he's told. That's why he's scared, because he knows. He knows, like, this stuff, okay? So, how does Trump feel? How does Trump feel? You know, guys, he's kind of happy about it, but he's also apprehensive because he feels, he feels like it was a message to him. He feels like they were like, bitch, we could do anything. Shut your mouth. You know, like, you know what I'm saying? So I feel like it has more to do, guys, you know, and let me, how do I say this? Okay, that's my sense. Now, the question I wanted to ask, in a way, I am kind of asking the same question twice. Because I want to know, what if I'm wrong? What if it's not the Russian? What if it's just some of these men, one or two of the, you know, could it be an isolated person? Let's say one of the millionaires or whatever. There's so many of them, right? Could it be one of the people he's been blackmailing? He was blackmailing, okay? Do you mind? Okay. So, you know what I mean? Wow, like, let me just ask. Could it be somebody, just a random, one of the people he blackmailed? Or was it a group? Was it a mob? I'm just to clarify here, okay? So, okay, let's just see here. Quick, see, guys, quick. Yeah, wow, guys, look. This is the people where they go swiftly, go with the sword. Look, the guy comes with a sword, with a weapon. And this is a card of something quickly. It was done, like I told you guys, it was done very quickly, swiftly. And this is the sun upside down. Why? When the thing was exposed. So it's almost like as soon as the material came out, they gave the order to execute the guy. So I swear to God, that's what it looked. That's what the card suggests anyway. This is the lady, guys, could be both. Usually some sort of rush or could be the wind. So anyway, so let me just get them one more on top, public. So the lady stuff, public. Okay. Okay. And then one on top of this one. What is it? Oh, look, the adulators. Okay. So again, the question is, could it be one of the people who, you know, who was blackmailed, or was it a group? So the adulators. Okay. Then let's do another one here, which is the something quick happening quickly. And then we have, oh, look, migration, movement, flight. Interesting. Guys, you know, could be that somebody flew in. This is also called an airplane flight. So they flew in to do this and could have already left the country if they are foreign. Oh, guys, look, the children crying. You see, this is why I feel like it is the human trafficking, right? That's what it feels like. Why are the children? This is not, sometimes if it goes Trump, no, but it's sort of like, guys, it's like sad events, bad news. Okay, so you see what I'm saying? So it's kind of like, it is, this tells me, at least thus far. Now let's just one more here. What do we have here? Here, anchor. Okay, so it was exposed. The thing was, whatever is exposed is bad news, is anchor. And then what do we have? Oh! God, I'm kind of like, have goosebumps, huh? Oh my god. Oh my God, guys. God. Wow. Guys, okay, guys, let me just put it out here because, and as you know, I've asked sometimes, like I said before, I'll remind you guys of the first attempt, it was legit. He really wanted to kill himself, but this time, everything to me here suggests that he was killed. It was not natural, okay? So let me tell you why again, because, guys, look at this. This is crazy, okay? So, oh my God, look. It was like this, right? And it was like this, and it was adulator, okay? So, this is. So guys, yeah, so here we have something quick, something was the woman stuff, okay. And then something public. Okay, one second. So this was a sun upside down. So okay, so just to show you quickly. Oh no, this was like this, right? It was like this. So then, okay, this is guys. Okay, so this is the stuff, this is the public. Okay, so once the thing came out in the public eye, okay, there was a swift order, and this is the adulators. Now, the fake, let me just one more about these adulators. Oh my God, guys, a hopeless. That's right, it was hope upside down. So this is, it could be also the scammers, okay, the flatterer, fake flatterer. So this is, okay, so. Fake flatterer, hopeless, and then wow, delays. So I feel, guys, this is, this is like as soon as the thing came out, something coming out, and this is something, they acted quickly because you have the thing about quick, and then you have the revelation. Then you have this card is interesting. This could be migration, guys. That's it. Could be human trafficking because you see the child crying and the flight. This is related to immigration, migration. Okay. And this is related to human tra I would think this is to me tells me human trafficking. And then the exposure, the anchor, guys, to me is something that is like for a long time. Sometimes it's connected to prison, and it could also mean that, like, guys, if you see these movies when they throw in the anchor, right, that put somebody in, it's almost like I feel like the order, it's like they have the plan in mind as soon as he was arrested. And when the whole thing came out, it was like the order was executed. Because guys, look, I'm sorry, this is a really creepy card. And when it's like this upside down, it's permanent ending. So there was orders to really kill him, execution style. Okay, so you see, it's kind of like this is, and this could also be if you look at it in a bigger scale, like Trump would be the adulator, right? So, but the adulator, he wants to protect the human trafficking. Okay, so you see what I'm saying? So the person connected to human trafficking. Okay, in other words, whoever's the adulator, somebody who is dependent. So it's either that what's his name? Oh my God. Oh, this is interesting. This is hopeless, right? So Epstein in this context could be the adulator because somebody else was the protector. He's not presented as the most powerful here. Okay. So the adulator felt hopeless but this is a card of wait. So they were waiting for this. Like they said, okay, if the information comes out, then we're going to execute the order. Okay. So that's what it feels like to me. Okay. Oh my God, guys, crazy, no? Wow. Wow, no? Wow. Outro sinal. Oh, very light. So, oh my God. Oh my God. Wow. That's it, guys. So what I mean by that, okay, so you guys, one of you said no questions, but I just read something, but it's interesting. So I feel like Trump knew, okay, did Trump, or maybe this is okay, guys. So let me just ask them the question. Did Trump know in advance that this was going to happen? Let's just ask that, okay? Did Trump know in advance at all? Did he know in advance? Let's just ask for, I'm just going to do this, guys, in this, okay? So did Trump know in advance that this, oh my God, oh my God, look. Oh my God. Oh no, it's true. It's true. Yeah. It's not imagining. Oh, Jesus help. Look, guys. Yeah. Oh, it's just a weapon. Don't worry about it. It's just an allegory. It's not real. No, it is. This time it is. Oh my God. Look at this, guys. Oh my God. Look at these two together. Very nice. Very quiet. Very happy. Oh my God. Woo. Oh my God. So the question is, did Trump know in advance? Oh my God. Oh. Costs, okay. Wow, interesting, guys. So these two cards, you know, these are women, but I don't think they necessarily mean women. It means that this is this card, guys, is a person who is a hustler, who's like a, you know, trickster. Is in some ways is like a trickster card. And this is a person who poses as a friend. And this is gossip. Okay, so this is like the harvest. If the person can collect the money, he's killed. And this is the, you know, this is the star upside down. This is something, in other words, not against the will of heaven. Okay. So scythe is what? This is the mountain. Sometimes it connects to prison also. But these long-term problems, we're going to cut. And there's going to be long-term problems because there was a deal. So in other words, guys, the suggestion here is that if you make a deal with the mob, they go after you if you fuck it up. That's what it's suggesting. So it didn't tell me exactly that he knew. Okay. I don't know that he knew. This old gossip. That, you know, they could be like not directly. Okay. So there was this is a mountain, in other words, long-term problems. And, you know, could be whispers. That's it. Whispers. They could be whispered. But let me just, this, I have to find a revision, guys. Did he know? Was he told? Did he know? Did Trump know that this was going to happen? How was he told? Guys, I swear, I see this guy, Dan Scovina, who is his social media manager. He's the guy I told you before. He reads the Russian like Twitter thing and tells him messages. So I feel like there was some sort of coded message in the Twitter thing among the things that he reads. And he was told, like, you know, kind of like a coded message, like a symbolic message. Oh, this person's going to fall, you know, something not like that. Never like this, but it's like a whisper, shh, you know, something like this. So then he hears the news and that's it. You know what I mean? And have you noticed, guys, he has not talked about Epstein very much because he knows, right? Guys, it's even deeper than we think. What I'm sensing here is that it's not even about the secrets, like the secrets about the men. It's about the business people, the mob kind of business of human trafficking that he has to protect because he made a deal with them. And guys, as you see, this is not conspiracy. Like they weakened the laws about human trafficking, right? You saw this. This is true. This is true. Oh my God. Oh my God. Yeah. Orders exactly. It's my God. Can you believe it? Yeah, no, I saw you guys. No, seriously. Oh my God, Janet, guys, I'm laughing, but it's not funny because he'll fly flags half mast tomorrow. Exactly. He doesn't care about the children dying in the shootings, but somebody killed because of the mob. You know. So, guys, and I'm getting the flash of, like, Manafort. He's like, I'm glad I didn't say anything. Manafort's like, no, I'm glad I didn't say anything. I'm fine. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's, wow. Guys, I'm sorry. I'm like, is it okay if I digest this? Because it's insane. I didn't know what I was expecting. You never know, right, what's going to happen. But I feel like this reading has been so direct and so to the point. There's no doubt. So at least for me, it was very clear, like the scene and everything. I saw the scene. I saw how it all happened, right? Oh my God. Whoa. Whoa. You know what I'm saying? Whoa. Guys, crazy. It's crazy. But I feel like somebody said, Flynn, but I think it's a little different here. This is about taking money from the Russian mob and having businesses with them. I don't think Flynn took money from foreign people, but I don't think he was quite, he was a little bit different. He's in a different category. I'm not protecting him, but this has to do with people who worked with them directly, you know, or like had these, you know, obviously Trump borrowed money from them and Manafort also owed money, you know, so it's a little, it's people who owe them money and stuff like that. It's a little different. But I'm not, you know, not protecting Flynn, but oh my God. Okay, guys. Wow. So guys, I'm not even going to ask the question about, is he alive? I don't think, no. I don't think he's alive. I'm sorry. No, I don't think he's alive. No. I don't think he's alive. Okay. No. Should I ask if he's alive? Should I ask if he's alive? No. Right. I think it's, to me, everything tells me that he's dead. Okay. So is Trump afraid for himself or his family? Is Trump afraid? Because guys, he was sweating in a way. That's right. I saw this thing on Twitter that he was sweating a lot. It was very unusual how much he was sweating. So is he afraid for himself or his, I mean, he doesn't care about his, I'm sorry. He doesn't care about anybody but himself. So is Trump afraid right now? Let's just ask. Is he afraid? Wow. Guys, this is a quid pro quo. So that he's like, yeah, they gave me money. Quid pro quo. You know the thing about the quid pro quo? If you don't pay back, bitch, cut you up. I'll cut you up. Oh, my God. Oh, child. Is it Trump? The president? Okay. Oh, my God. Oh. Money losses. That's it. He's like, I owe them money. Guys. He's just like Manafort. He owes them money. That's it. He owed them money. He lost their money. And he's like, I owe them money. This is it. Money losses, right? So I owe them. For some reason, guys, it's saying here, I owe them money. Oh, my God. I'm like, whoa. It's kind of crazy, guys. Even for me. You know, let me just put it like, because, you know, what I'm saying, look at this. I owe them money. Can you believe it? Oh, my God. Whoa. Oh, look. Oh, my God. The White House, guys. White House. Jesus Christ. Oh, look, just to tell us twice, the White House twice. Okay, it could also be houses, but I do think it's the White House twice. I mean, hello, right? Look at the White House. This is like a home. So, wow, look, he's unstable. Constanza, it says a person who could leave or he's unstable. He's like freaking out. He's out of it. Changes. Oh, secrets. Sakarta secrets. Oh, yeah. There's going to be changes about... Oh, my God. Guys, you know, this is... I made a mistake. This is a snake, but let me just get... Oh, guys, victory. Interesting. Guys, secrets about his victory. That's right. You know why? Oh, this is it, guys. He owes his victory to the Russian mob. That's it. He owes them his victory. Literally, not only he owes the victory. Look, the victory has to do with... Oh, my God, guys. Look at what this suggests. This suggests that his victory, he became president to pay off his losses to them. He owed them money before he became president, and that's how he was going to pay them back. And he feels things are changing once my secrets come out about how I earned victory. And they did a victory. That's it. Boom. Bada bang, bada boom. You know what I mean? That's it. I gave them victory. Boom. That's it. Oh, my God, guys. Can you believe it? You know, that's it. That's what it's saying. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Wow. Can you believe it? Wow. Oh, my God, guys. Whoa. I'm like, I'm dealing. I'm dealing with it. Wow. But, guys, I swear that I think the things, you know, the image I saw, whenever I see Trump on, I don't want to watch it. I don't listen. I can't, you know, most of us can't. But I saw, like, he was really nervous, okay? So this is it. He knows that the whole White House is at stake. The White House, they gave the White House. So, guys, in other words, I just summarize here. The same people who killed Epstein are connected to giving him the White House. Oh, interesting, no? Oh. So, and it's saying this is why he doesn't want to give his information, the tax information, not because he's poor, but because he's connected to these people in the tax things. It says that they own his... That's it. He's saying that... Oh, my God, guys. This is it. Oh my God. Sorry. I just hit myself. I hurt a little. Like, I hit myself because that's it. So obvious. You know what's saying, guys? That the Trump business, it was just a front. That the real... Like, there was two books. There was the real books and the fake books. And that the Russians owned the books. In other words, that, like, they own his businesses. All he has is the name. Right? Oh, my God, guys. It's kind of crazy. I can't even... It makes it so... Now, guys, it's so clear. It's so clear. You know what I mean? Wow. So this is it, you know? So this is it, guys, you know? And like I said, I'm not like... Okay, I'm not taking questions. Like I said, if you had questions, you have to put it on the thing. Because the thing... did all the secrets... Like, guys, remember the thing how I am, you know? No generic questions. Like, all the secrets... Like, no, obviously not. Because the documents... Think about it, right? It's on Friday... The judge mandated that 2,000 documents are released, and they were released, a lot of them. They're still going to release more. So clearly not all the secrets are not with, you know, with him. But, you know, this is guys, one step at a time. OK, because this is very intense. Because like I said, I don't want to give you, you know, a lot of people like, oh, I have the answer. I know this. Never trust people who give you like the perfect answer. You know, it has to do with like getting the facts together and the context. You need the context more than you need, you know, so that's what I mean. So, oh my God, guys, I'm like still kind of like, whoa. So, wow. Okay. So then the question, next question is, What happens to all the powerful men involved? Will the powerful men? Okay, I'm just gonna list, guys. There's so many questions. Like, I don't have time. Okay, how much time we have? It's been how long? Okay, it's been how long? It's been how long? 1 hour and a half. I feel like let's do another half hour. Okay, after that, I'm gonna start getting really tired. So, but I think we still have half hour. Okay. So now let me focus here on what the other, there's so many questions here, guys. Okay, so now what are the other questions? So, okay, so let me think here. What questions do I have that are important here? So first is, okay, I think that the next question I have that is not even, I don't know if I even listed there, is whether the FBI know that these men are, is, because I'm kind of have the question about the blackmail, you know, is the information going to come out of blackmail? Also, because guys, how do I say this? Again, my sense, and I'm not defending the rich men who did this, not at all. But what I'm saying is that in degree of evil, the worst people are the worst of the worst are the ones who traffic the women, who make money from them having sex with these men, which they then record. So this is like why there's many different, it's almost like there's different constituents. Okay, different markets or whatever you call it, you know. So this is the thing. I want to know so that's why it's two separate questions we should ask. A is whether okay, because they killed a guy, obviously this is a huge thing. Is the business of human trafficking going to be exposed, even though he was silenced? Are we going to find out about it? Is it going to be exposed or no? Or is that it? That's the first question. The second question is, what about the famous men that were obviously filmed with these women? What happens to them? Because that's the difference we have to spell out here, right? Because I do believe from what the cards say is that the men who killed the guy were not the famous guys, were the guys who collect the cash. So you know, who are business partners of Epstein that we don't know about, okay? So in a way, he was very convenient because it was like he was a scapegoat in some ways. I'm not saying that he's not awful. He is awful, but what in order for how can we end this human trafficking? You have to expose the business of human trafficking. So is this going to be exposed? Even, you know, has Epstein given information? And if he has given information, is this going to be exposed? And then we ask about the famous. Is that okay? I think this is interesting, guys, you know. So let's first ask, is this going to blow the whole thing wide open about the human? Is it going to expose the business? That's what I want to know. The business of human trafficking and the people behind it. Not the men who have sex with the girls. That's a little bit separate. But let's find out, okay? So this is like this. Is that right? Yeah, right? No, sorry. It's upside down for me. So, okay. Oh, wow, we're leaving. Oh, my God. So the question is this going to expose the men, the structure of money laundering, okay? Like the man behind money laundering. Is this going to expose? Oh, guys, look. Is this going to expose the business of money laundering? Who's behind it, okay? Wow. So, guys, okay, you know, this reminds me of Trump. This is a person leaving, and this is death, okay? And this is a woman widower. Now, we have seen actual death now, but so the question is it going to be exposed? The answer, the key is yes, because this card, this is known as the most important card. And always, whenever this card comes up, it tells us this is the answer. In other words, there's going to be an answer. Okay. Offer. Okay. So here we have the King of Cups. Let's find out more. Lovers upside down. That's right. Okay. And money. This is money of the boss. And this is a reconciliation. This is when people shake hands, make a deal. Somebody is going to break apart. Okay, and talk about this money, I think. This is offers an answer, and this is sick. Okay, so then we have, but then we have somebody leaving, an ending, and a widower. So in other words, the question is this going to be exposed? Okay, what I think it's, I have to always look at the card. So the card's saying, you know, this is connections. People are offered things to leave, but I think, guys, there's going to be endings, okay? I think people are going to leaving, ending. Widower, people, guys, it says people, you know, sickness, the answer to the sickness. So I think we're going to have some answers here. Okay, let me just find out more. It's not specific enough for me, but so how are we going to find out? Are there going to be arrests connected to this business of money laundering? How is this going to come out? What is going to come out? It's guys are saying it's going to come out through Trump's finances. Trump's finances are connected to Epstein's in some way because the source, there's like this global money laundering effort. Okay, it's saying, the reason why, oh my God, he's saying, oh my God, guys, they're saying the reason why Trump and Epstein were connected, because at the end of the day, they were like, you know, imagine if the Russian mob is like holdings, right? Different holdings. So they were a little, Trump was a company, Epstein was another. So they it's almost like, for example, let's say, you know, I'm trying to think, like Johnson & Johnson has different brands, you know, like it's like a mega, like, you know, so they were one separate brand in a big conglomerate. That is how it connects here. But is the human trafficking business going to be exposed? Yes. They're going to flee the country, guys. It's saying the Russian, you know, so guys, it's remember how the day I saw, I told you guys, there's going to be arrests and like, they're going to have to leave the country, but it's going to be, because, you know, it's like they have to freeze the money. It's a very dangerous situation here, guys, but it's, you know, this is crazy, God. But it's guys, you know, it's all connected. It's saying that's why Trump is connected to the sex thing, because he made money from it. And this is all connected to money laundering. It's kind of the same I say, you know, the mob does money laundering, human trafficking, sometimes drugs. So it's kind of how the money is laundered. That's how they connect. Wow, it's kind of crazy. Oh my God, guys, can you imagine? Oh my God. So, okay, tell me somebody's going, how is this going to be exposed? Has Epstein given information to the cops? Or were they able to find information in his, like, you know, whatever, you know, his money, you know, his whatever. Were they able to find information about this in his like, documents? They're saying yes, but there's more. They have been investigating this for a long time. It's like there's a lot of complicated LLCs and there's a lot of different things, but it could be. It's like, it's so interesting. He's telling me more, it's more than people. It's bank accounts. The bank accounts are the thing. Not even like one, it's not about one person talking. It's almost saying like a person talking is irrelevant. What is relevant is the money. That's why the good thing about this type of business is that it's financial. So finances can be traced, as opposed to people are not going to tell the truth. They're only going to tell part of the truth. So you don't really know what is what, but money flows, you know, and it's a thing. It's real. It's concrete. So like, It's the money trail. That's why Trump is so afraid of money trail. And that is why he doesn't like to do the taxes. That's it. It's not just because he's not as rich as he claims, but because he's owned by the mob. Okay. Oh, and his taxes are going to reveal the mob businesses. That's right. He's going to reveal the LLCs that own his businesses. And that is going to, how it's going to trace. That's it. Oh my God, guys. Crazy today. Jesus. Interesting, no? Wow. My God. Wow. So this is just about the money laundering. Okay. I'm sorry. The human trafficking. That's it. Now let's go to the men who are famous and who were filmed with these women. All these men, which is a different category, as you saw, right? So what about the men that are famous, as businessmen, governors, whatever, whoever. Okay. So what's going to happen to them? Okay. Oh my God. Okay. Sorry. Separating the cards. Okay. So what's going to happen to these men? Okay. So what's up with them? You know, what's happening with them? Okay. Wow, guys, can I tell you? Oh my God, this is kind of crazy. Okay, this is a card of, this is shady business. Okay, this is election or multiple. Okay, it could be both the Trump election, but it could also be multiples of you know, they could be have shady businesses. Now, this is what I was wanted to tell you guys. This is women upside down, and this is a card of the afternoon tryst. Okay, so this could tell us many things. This could be businesses connected to multiple afternoon trysts. This could be real estate businesses. This could also be this, and this is what I want to tell you. This is interesting. Okay. It tells me, this is kind of like, in a way, it seems like obvious in retrospect, but not obvious until now, that they were forced to donate to the Trump campaign. Okay, that's kind of what I'm getting here. It sounds so strange, because here we have the trap, and this is an offer. As I told you guys, you know, the whole thing was like, this is the world, the initial thing. So they were offered because they were trapped. This is money offerings because they were trapped. And this is the election offerings. Or the offerings to the man. Okay, so multiple offerings to the man because they were trapped. So this is a new beginning. This is Ace of Swords victory. And this is the protector upside down. So in other words, these men were the ones who were also protecting Epstein. Okay, because they were trapped and they didn't want the information to come out. So even though they were trapped, they were also protecting him because of all these things. But I think this is the multiple offers to the man. It could, like I said, it could also be, it could be, you know, but let's see, what was the question? What happens to them? Okay, so just a, one, you know what, guys, I'm kind of like intrigued by this. Okay, so one more. Okay, wedding. Okay, exposed, comes up. This is public, becomes public, okay? So, wow, the world. Wow, guys, this goes all, it's so, this, these two connected are big. The world is completion. It's also obviously something foreign. So this becomes moon, becomes famous, and the deals, okay? So, yeah, so everything, I think this comes out. And like I said, guys, it's very much tied to finances, okay? So let me just ask, is this, that's, let me just ask this question because it's so crazy. Okay. So is this true then that because they, oh, this is the question, guys, I forgot to ask. So did, oh my God, I think I asked this en passant, but let me ask again, are these men connected to, how do I say this, guys? Did Trump have blackmailed these men based off of information Epstein gave him? Okay. In other words, you know, did he use, somebody asked, I forgot who, said, asked me something like, you know, did Trump have information about Democrats from Epstein? And we're, you know, so that's kind of the, what it suggests here, something like this, like he had information, but let me just ask this directly. I can make, like I was telling you guys, I can make the assumption. So did Trump have information about specific Democrats? Or, yeah, let's just say Democrats, okay, because, or anybody, let's just say anybody, it doesn't necessarily, right? Or like, did Epstein give Trump information that he could use, that he's using while he's president because of compromise? Okay, let's, is that clear? I think it's a very important question. Okay, right? So it, did Trump give, did Epstein give Trump information, compromise information about politicians or businessmen or whatever that Trump used to blackmail them into doing what he wanted? Okay, let's, this is the question. Okay, so this, what is this? This is factions. This is, yeah, this is interesting, right? This is a person who's tied. Okay, so the question is, did Epstein give Trump information about these men? Okay, so, wow. Okay, so did Trump, oh, wow, look. You know what, let me just get these other cards, guys, too. So here we have clouds, unclear, or something behind the scenes, foreign, and getting what they wanted, loyalty. Okay, this is the factions, in other words, competition, or, you know, or type, or exposure of the enemy. Okay, and then we have here, they were trapped by the foreign people and Trump. That's right. Here we have the center, guys, as a foreign. So maybe, you know what, maybe Epstein gave the foreign people the thing. Okay, but that is Trump, guys. He gave those people who were trapped. I think it's the same business, ultimately. You know what I mean? Like, they're, since they all worked for the main organization, then you see what I'm saying? Then, of course, they would all have access to the same thing, ultimately, right? So let me just find out this information. So, did Epstein give Trump something or not about these people, his, you know, political enemies or whatever? And okay. Wow, good luck at the White House, guys. Yeah, this is interesting. So yes, I think yes. Okay, now let's get more, you know, information here. So you have here the factions and somebody trapped. They can't leave. And this is a will, like this is willpower, but sometimes this is a card, sometimes it can come up with when people are abused by like a partner. This is like the abusive type upside down, it's like a mentality of like having too much control. And this is the dream or their goal. This is loyalty. Now this is the past. Okay, so. So this, yes, I think this could be used as a means about clouds behind the scenes, okay, to exert. This is the sickness. It could be that if they have some sort of like, you know, what they call some sort of perversion. And I don't mean it in a moral way. I mean it, right? They could have been recorded doing something that would make them look bad in public. Look, they're trapped. Here's the foreign power. Here is the, you know, the orange man here and then the White House. So, and this is the shady past. So I feel like he could use it, secrets about these people's past, to, you know, to make them do things they don't want to do. That's my sense. Okay. So yeah, it is kind of extortion, right? That's what it is in some ways, right? That's wow. Let me just kind of, guys, it gets crazier and crazier. Okay. So let me just confirm here. So tell me that, okay. So did Epstein give Trump information about these men and say, oh my God, Sammy, Trump operated blackmail businesses for a long time. He's saying he knew a lot. It's not just because he became president. He knew about this. And this is kind of how he knew he could win. It's because he had ways to manipulate the people. And they're saying the mob people, whatever, Epstein, they all came together like, oh, we could make it, you know. And that in a way, you're saying that Epstein was out of favor because he was scapegoated, right? He fell. And but he you know, he's alive. He was kept alive because he didn't say anything about anybody. That's why. Okay, so. Wow. Guys, this is crazy. Okay, so is the, okay, let me, this is the other thing I need to know. So is there information? Does the FBI or the good people in law enforcement have information about how this blackmail operated? And they have information about how Trump blackmailed people, and it's going to come out. You know, because if it shows, guys, on top of all the crimes, are we ever going to find out? Is it ever going to become public that Trump blackmailed people into doing certain things? Okay, I want to know. I need to live in my house, right? Like, that's it. Is it going to come out? Because I don't care that he did it or not, but what I want to know is it going to come out. In other words, is it going to be, you know, go against? We need the truth about Trump, guys, to be exposed. We need to know. If on my house, I need that. You know? Wow. Okay. So, you know what I mean? So, okay. So, all right. So let's see. Is it going to, okay. So be careful what you wish for. Oh, wow. Focus. Okay. The money. Okay. Wow. Money, guys. Oh my God. I ran out of these cards, but oh, look, this is the good. Okay. Oh, the group people. Let me just get from these other cards here then. So yeah, this is the transmission money. That's right. Money transfers. Okay. So the question is again, what is, oh guys, interesting, the fake friend. So is there evidence? Oh guys, look, the law. Wow, the theft. Okay, so guys, you know what's telling me here is that this is financial information, financial transfers of laundered money, and the law is going to go after the people in his like org chart. And this is, be careful what you get for. This is interesting because this, guys, these two cards are kind of similar. This is the good person or the loyalist. And this is a person who is good, but either a person who kind of pretends to be good. So it's almost as if informants, this is my sense, there's informants, okay, here that show, that have evidence of how this money, because what is, if you think about it, what is evidence? It's finances, right? Like I said, whatever somebody says is difficult to say. It's not enough to get put somebody in jail. It's more about the money is the evidence. Okay, so here we see, guys. You see what I'm saying? So like, wow, my God. This is proven through the financial transfer. So, but I want to know, guys, it doesn't tell me. Okay, so it tells me more about, okay, so how this is being infiltrated. But okay, is there evidence? This is what I want to know. Maybe I'm asking again, but I need to know. Is there evidence that Trump has been blackmailing people? And is there evidence? And is it going to be prosecuted? Okay, maybe it's already said, but I this is like so important to me that I need to know. Is there evidence that Trump has been blackmailing people? And if so, is this going to come out? Okay, so wait. Oh my God, what? Oh, I guess it was mixed here. I don't know. Yeah, I haven't seen this one. So is there evidence that Trump was, oh, look, guys, a lot of money upside down. So is there evidence that Trump was black? Oh, look, conversation. Is there evidence that Trump was blackmailing people? And is this going to come out? Yeah, there is. This is card of information. Guys, this is conversation. In other words, people around each other. So this is quietly somebody's angry and there's conversations. Then we have something, aggression, a young man. Like, remember, I don't know, guys, Jared, you know, I wonder, let's say more, look. Yeah, men who are losing money. Okay, this, I wonder, you know, if Jared knows, somebody, is there a man here, okay? And then this is somebody receives a letter that is sad, very sad letter, right? Somebody's crying because they receive information. What is this? Literato is information, look at the books. So somebody has a lot of information, right? And here people are worried. All these people are worried. There's a lot of money involved. and there's information. So in other words, I feel like somebody is talking. Okay. People are kind of talking on the down low. Okay. And it's financial. Okay. Oh my God, guys. Isn't that crazy? Isn't that crazy? Oh my God. So let me just find out. Yeah, it's complicated, but I think it's telling, oh guys, you know, I'm getting Roger Stone. You know, Roger Stone was, you know, the dirty trickster people. You know, it's always the trap. It's, what is that? It's traffic of information. This person has that dirt, you know, their secrets or whatever. So that it's like they sell secrets of others, and that's kind of how it is. It's a financial thing. Oh my God, guys, can you? I'm just like, well, so, you know what it feels like? Like, you know, when you're sick, you have a stomach flu or something, and you start vomiting and you never stop vomiting. That's what it feels like. It never ends. You know what I mean? It never ends. Isn't that crazy? Oh my God. It never ends. It never ends. So, wow. So guys, okay. Okay. Now two questions. Okay. I want to ask, about this Ghislaine woman. What happens to her? What is she, you know, be careful, girl. I don't mean to be, you know, but, so what happens to Ghislaine? Okay. And what happens to the case? Let's see, you know, that's what happens to the case.